Hallelujah. Let us pray. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, thank you for Jesus Christ given to us to be the way, the truth, and the life. And thank you for calling us to be a part of the wonderful story of our Lord. Thank you for the celebration of Easter, which marks the resurrection of our Lord, and which is the basis of our Christian faith, which faith also helps us to preach the gospel in order to bring men and women to the saving knowledge of Christ. We pray that you will grant us the Spirit to interpret your word. May your word alone be preached without any contamination. May your word only be preached without any adulteration. May that saving word be preached. And on this occasion, help us by the power of the Holy Spirit to meditate on your word. And so draw us closer to yourself and to one another in your word. In Jesus' name we have prayed with thanksgiving. Amen. My dear sisters and brothers, this Friday of our usual Friday devotion, I'd like for us to read the passage which is in the lectionary for the day. The lectionary appointed for the day is Acts chapter 13, verse 26 to 33. Acts 13, 26 to 33. And I read the word. Brothers, sons of the family of Abraham, and those among you who fear God, to us has been sent the message of this salvation. For those who live in Jerusalem and their rulers, because they did not recognize him nor understand him. Understand the utterances of the prophets which are read every Sabbath, fulfill them by condemning him. And though they found in him no guilt worthy of death, they asked Pilate to have him executed. And when they had carried out all that was written of him, they took him down from the tree and laid him in the tomb. But God raised him from the dead. And for many days he appeared to those who had come up with him from Galilee to Jerusalem, who are now his witnesses to the people. And we bring you the good news that what God promised to the fathers, this he has fulfilled to us, their children, by raising Jesus, as also it is written in the second Psalm, "You are my son, today I have begotten you." Beloved, this is the word of God. My dear sisters and brothers, I invite you to meditate today on the theme, overcoming evil with good. Overcoming evil with good. And this is based on the readings for the day, the reading that I've just done. Overcoming evil with good. And let me remind us that we are still in the mood of Easter. celebrating the fact that Jesus rose again from the dead. And the fact that the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ sets out lessons for us to learn as Christians. And one of the lessons that the resurrection teaches us is the fact that God is able to overcome evil with good. God is able to overcome evil with good. Hence, our theme for today, overcoming evil with good. And my anchor text is part of the reading. And it says, when they had carried out all that was written of him, they took him down from the tree and laid him in a tomb. But God raised him from the dead. Acts 13, 29 and 30. In the passage, we see St. Paul preaching in the synagogue at Antioch, which is in the region of Pisidia. Paul and his missionary friend Barnabas were doing what Christians are called to do today. They're preaching the gospel so as to bring men and women to the saving knowledge of Christ. Paul and Barnabas went to the synagogue and first they sat down and listened to the word of God as was read from scriptures, from the law and the prophets. Then the rulers of the synagogue said to them, brothers, if you have any word of encouragement for the people, say it. If you have word, any word of encouragement to the people, say it. And I find this to be a passionate appeal to the apostles, to Paul and Barnabas, to help edify the people of God in the word. And for me, this also shows the humility of these rulers of the synagogue. They were theologians. They were men of letters in the word of God. But they still showed humility before the apostles, before St. Paul and St. Barnabas, asking that the people may be edified. Beloved, no matter our status in the church, no matter our position in the church, no matter our pedigree, we need the word of God. We need deeper knowledge and understanding of the word. And we need people to minister the word of God to us. We may be the best of theologians, but we still need somebody to minister the word to us. The Bible says that the word is a light under our feet. It's a lamp that shows us the way out of darkness to the clear and marvelous light in Jesus Christ. So we need the word. No matter our background, no matter our pedigree, we need a deeper knowledge and understanding of the word of God. The hymn writer says, Lord, thy word abideth and our footsteps guided who is truth believeth, light and joy receiveth. And in response to the appeal of the religious leaders, Paul stood up to preach. He preached the fact that the coming of Jesus Christ is a consummation of history. He preached the fact that the history of the Jews culminates in Jesus Christ, who was crucified. The Jews killed him, but God raised him. In raising Jesus from the dead, God demonstrates the fact that good always triumphs over evil. And we are called to overcome evil with good. Let me walk you through some biblical antecedents. In the Old Testament, Joseph's brothers meant to destroy him. So they sold him into slavery. But he was vindicated in the sense that he became a great man in Egypt. In Genesis chapter 45, Joseph fulfilled the biblical truth that we should overcome evil with good. So he forgave his erring, wicked brothers and found a home for them in Egypt. Joseph forgave them. He simply forgave them. Again, in the Old Testament, despite the hatred and the persecutions Saul meted out to David, David demonstrated grace in forgiving Saul. In 1 Samuel chapter 24, we see how David spared Saul's life. He could have killed Saul, but he spared his life, overcoming evil with good. In 1 Samuel 24 and verse 17, Saul himself acknowledged the fact that good always triumphs over evil, and the fact that we can overcome evil with good. Listen to what he said. You are more righteous than I, for you have repaid me good, whereas I have repaid you evil. Here, David triumphed over the evil and the wicked intentions of Saul. And Jesus Christ on the cross showed forgiveness to demonstrate that it is possible to overcome evil with good. The Jews killed him, but God raised him up, overcoming evil with good. Beloved, today I invite you to overcome evil with good, showing forgiveness like Joseph. And God will vindicate you. He will make you big, like Joseph. You will be the head and not the tail. I invite you to forgive, to overcome evil with good, like David, and God will vindicate you. Like David, he will prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies. Above all, I invite you to overcome evil with good, like Jesus Christ, and you will be a true disciple of our Lord. May the resurrection power then help us overcome evil with good, wherever we find ourselves, in our homes, in our workplaces, and of course in the church. Let this godly attitude be in us, that we may always find a way of overcoming evil with good, with the good things that we do, in our lives will never be the same. Overcome evil with good. Let us pray. So, Heavenly Father, we come to you in the name of the risen Lord Jesus Christ once again. Thanking you for the lesson that we have drawn from the story of the resurrection. And we have learned the lesson about forgiveness, which will help us overcome evil with good. Grant us a grace so to do, so to forgive. Grant us a grace so to forgive in the face of all difficulties in our hurt and injury. Let us look to you, the initiator and the perfecter of our faith, knowing that even as we look to you and are drawn to the cross, living in the shadow of the cross, we can sincerely learn the virtues of the cross. And so forgive each other. And so bring peace and prosperity into our relationships. Let that Christ-like attitude inebriate us and take absolute control of our lives. We have made our prayer in the name and spirit of Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, ever one God, world without end. Amen. And now we receive the benediction. The Lord be with you. My sisters and brothers, may the love of God enfold you and draw you unto himself and to one another. May Jesus Christ, who is a good shepherd, lead you every step of the way in your pilgrimage. And may the Holy Spirit, who sanctifies, sanctify each one of you for every good work. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, so bless, preserve, and keep you this day and forevermore. Amen.
Oh,